I will introduce myself. I'm Samir Munir. As you know, we have met earlier also. So I'm Samir Munir. I'm working as corporate trainer in Koenig Solutions. I have more than 14 years of experience, and I deliver many courses, including this Puppet and DevOps tools related many courses like Ansible, Puppet, Chef also I'm preparing, then configuration management tools. One of them is Puppet, then Docker, Kubernetes related to container management, then Git, Jenkins, Elasticsearch, Elk Stack, and related to Kubernetes, various courses like CKA, that is Certified Kubernetes Administrator, CKS, CKD, from Azure, AKS, and Kubernetes Administration using Docker. And those are some latest technology courses, but based on basic operating systems also, I deliver courses like Red Hat related courses also, like Red Hat System Administration 1, 2, 3, that is basic, intermediate, advanced, we can say. It is RHCSA, RHCE, that is Red Hat Certified System Administrator, Red Hat Certified System Engineer actually. So Red Hat Certified Engineer and SUSE related courses also. Means many distributions of Linux operating system, including SUSE, CentOS, CompShell, Linux. And I have done certifications related to that Red Hat, that is RHCSA, Red Hat Certified System Administrator, and Red Hat Certified Engineer. So it is in brief, and the skill sets, those I deliver, some brief skill sets list here, and some of the company's name where I have provided training, and the recent client's feedback also. And these are some feedbacks from my clients. And it is from scratch we are doing. We are using CentOS 7 virtual machines. So same setup, which we will see how to deploy this. So you can create own setup also using Oracle VirtualBox or VMware Workstation or any virtualization technology. Microsoft has Hyper-V, Linux has Xen, KVM. So it is redirecting to your, yes, Casper's antivirus. So there is some certificate related exception we have to accept. Yes. Yes, certificate you have to accept. If it is your office laptop, I request please use it in different system. Is it office laptop or it is personal? Sometimes if it is office laptop, proxy and many things
This is my own personal laptop.
Okay, no problem. So you have to accept that certificate. It is giving error for that certificate, but you have to accept. Again, refresh that web page.
Okay. Yes, vSphere.
Yes, it is VMware vSphere we are using. Click on launch. And there that username password from second tab in this browser. That username password from first and second field.
So only 3 days this will work.
Generally, this lab is available for course duration, maybe till midnight on last day.
No one can change the password, right? The password will be same
yes,
only,
yes,
right?
Yes, the one yes. Which it will be same for that the course duration. So copy paste sometimes. Easy also and sometimes problem else. Yes, now expand the arrows from left side from data center. There is left side one arrow. Yes, expand it. Same, expand that IP address. Expand that username and you will find these three machines. So we'll use these three machines. One will be as a master and other two will be used as a node. So we'll create a cluster.
Okay.
Puppet related. And Puppet, again, you may be familiar, it is open source and paid. Like I have mentioned, Kubernetes is also open source and vendor services. So itself, Puppet has Puppet Enterprise. We have discussed in a demo also earlier. So it is open source and paid. So our course is completely on open source. But yes, I will show some basic examples, basic demo, how to use Puppet Enterprise also. Okay. So yes,
okay, we'll, what this is happening,
it is started just below that some icon is there, like a console of that machine. Below there is one button, launch web console. So below summary, one icon square is there, actually rectangular shape.
That is gone.
No problem. So there is one window below summary for that virtual machine, like screen.
Yeah. This I
below
know,
that
this,
below that there one know. Yes, there was is one
this
button.
Is a console.
Yes, console. So there is one button to launch. Launch web console. Please click on that launch web console below that rectangular shape. Yes. So it will open that virtual machine to access.
Yeah, console of the
virtual machine. Okay, so here, right click on blank spot anywhere. And anywhere, blank spot. And last option, open terminal. To run the commands, we need terminal. Then you can zoom in using view menu. Yes, su hyphen or sudo su hyphen, no problem. Password is CentOS if it is asked. Okay, so if we use su hyphen, it may ask password, that is CentOS, CentOS in small letters.
Okay,
and you can zoom in from view menu. There is one keyboard button mentioned in same terminal. View menu, there are menu, multiple menus. Third menu is view. Inside it, to zoom in, there is one option, control plus keyboard combination also there, but you have to use with shift. So control shift plus keyboard combination, and plus from the, there are plus two type of places on Kia laptop if we have full-fledged keyboard. So plus from the left side of the backspace, that typing area. Control shift plus combination to zoom in.
Yeah, control shift left side and then plus.
Control shift plus, not left side. From the left side of backspace, generally it is there. Control shift and plus. Because why we use shift? Because it is single key having is equal to also and plus on single key, same key.
No, it's not expanding more. This is what it. One minute.
No, zoom. It is expanded. We want to zoom. So go to the view menu. You will find that shortcut also. Please click on view menu. So yes, click on that button also from mouse. It is possible. Or keyboard shortcut. Keyboard shortcut is, you can find it is showing control plus right side in same line. So that combination is control shift plus, because plus it is on same key. So how we use like underscore and dash on same key. So we use with shift without shift. Yes.
Control shift plus plus it is. Yes. Yeah, actually.
And control minus to zoom out without shift now.
Control shift minus minus. Okay.
No, without shift. Now minus is control without a shift. Yes, without shift.
Okay.
Yes, control minus to zoom out, control shift plus to zoom in.
Control okay. Minus.
You can try that also. Control minus to zoom out, control shift plus to zoom in. Without view menu, directly from keyboard. Using
control
keyboard.
Plus minus it is.
Yes, but on keyboard, we use plus with shift. If you check your keyboard, we use plus with shift.
Keyboard is not allowing me to use shortcuts, it seems.
Okay, no problem. I will share my screen just to show the demo. And again, you can share your screen. Just 1 minute. I hope my screen is visible. I'm trying to use Control Shift Plus like this, zoom in, Control Minus to zoom out. Same
keyboard buttons. That's what I'm doing.
Okay.
But
okay.
It's not operating it from on the console.
In same tab, please check again.
It's happening. Control minus.
Control minus to zoom out and Control Shift Plus. It is equal to. Without shift, it is equal to. That's why we need shift.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Same button having is equal to and plus. So how we use plus with shift?
No, I was using other plus minus.
Yes. So it is additional plus minus, so separate numerical keypad is also there. That's why I was saying left side of the backspace. There is plus and minus buttons.
Okay.
Because the right one, that numerical keypad won't work.
Okay.
Yes, you are trying that plus minus from numerical keypad, separated plus minus numbers are there. So it is not supported there. We can use either it is backspace left side or besides that backspace. Sometimes it is exactly left side, sometimes it is up down also. Yeah. So generally it is left side of the backspace button. So that plus and one more left side key, that is for minus from backspace. Then yes, it is the lap. Yes, you can use escape to exit from this full screen from
Control
this virtual
Alt machine. Also, no?
Yes, it is also possible to release the cursor. Control Alt to release cursor, escape to undo the full screen, no problem. Then go to the second tab again for student details in browser. Second tab, student details, LET portal. Yes, we have used this. So you can keep a note of this link and username password also. It is available from here also. But for easy, like you have used Notepad, in that Notepad also, you can use that three lines. That Windows 10 and that Windows 10 password will not required. So at least that first three columns. First, a third link, third column is for link. First column is for usernames and second column is for password. It is available, but for handy use, keep it in one notepad. All these three details, that link to access this Koenig lab, DC lab, and username password which is required. So I have shared one document. I will share that link in chat. It is from etherpad.opendev.org for sharing the notes, for running the commands and everything. This document and some cluster creation related steps are there. We'll add content to this. So Puppet for system administrators, this course, prerequisites. So we'll do this prerequisite. I will show this demo also, and then you can do all this. So first prerequisite, then installation of this Puppet. So how to do that configuration on first master means, this first machine we'll use as a master, and these two machines as a node one, node two. So clients. And on Puppet Master, we will see how to install, how to do configuration related to our Puppet configuration.
Okay.
And then some configuration related to client side, it is agent. So we'll see that theory part also, but first we'll do this configuration and then we will go for that theory part related to cluster, what is Puppet, everything. We'll see that architecture also, how it works. Okay. So first we'll do this configuration and then we will go with theory and then all the content related to this course.
Okay.
Yes. So I hope it is This link works for you. Is it open? Is it showing content?
You pinged in the chat. Okay, one.
Yes, in chat I have shared that. And same link can be accessed in virtual machine also. If I go to the virtual machine in applications, there is browser. It can be opened in physical system in that browser where we are accessing all this content. And we can go to our first virtual machine, which we have launched for web console from here. And inside that also from application menu, there is Firefox browser. From here also, we can open that. So for reference within that virtual machine, for physical machine also, it will be available. So from here also, I'm opening it.
I can't copy this in the notepad. Huh?
Yes, you can copy it. All those content you can copy to your notepad. And I will add content to this document as we go with the topics. I'm using same link etherpad. Here I have to type because we cannot.
It's an online notepad kind of
thing. Yes. And we can copy paste on physical, but we cannot copy paste in virtual machine. So here I am typing that link. Is visible here also in physical system in Chrome browser, for example, and here it is Firefox. Inside Firefox we are using
just a meta. Okay. I saved it.
Okay.
Yeah, you were saying something?
I was saying so, like it is from physical also available and in virtual machine from Firefox browzer also it is.
So do you want me to start copy pasting these commands in the
No. I will show demo first and then you will do. Okay. Because to avoid it is very simple task, but to avoid the confusion, to avoid the misconfiguration, theory demo and then your hands-on. Like that we will go. Simultaneously also you can do. And if you need additional time for practice also, we can do that. Either simultaneously or after my demo. Any method. As per to our convenience, we can go for that. So yes, I have one terminal opened here. We have multiple machines, but we can access them remotely. So these IP addresses we can use. So you can find in this vSphere. It is first machine. Its IP address is 172.25.230.236. Second machine in win same network 172.25 common. And 231.78 here for a second machine, here 230.240. So we'll use that IP addresses. So we can use these IP addresses to first configure the name resolution using etc hosts. So to check the IP address, we can use ifconfig command also on all machines, or from that console also here vSphere also we can find it. So any method we can use. And we'll edit our etc host file with first machine's IP, second machine's IP, third machine IP, replace this. And at least this single word also possible, puppet, node 1, node 2, or space separated with domain name also we can use, like imaginary domain name, example.com. It is not actual domain registered or purchased. So puppet.example.com and puppet, two names to this single IP, same. node1.example.com with domain name, without domain name, second machine. And we'll create this file on our Puppet first machine master. And we'll copy that file to that multiple machines using secure copy. So I will show that first how to do it. we are inside it. In terminal, we'll open that file. But before opening file, I will check my IP address. Ifconfig command, there are many interfaces. We'll check first one when we have used that command. Next line is for that ENS192. It is our LAN card in virtual machine. And line which begins with INET, it is our IP address, IPv4. So I'm copying this IP address from here. And then I will open a file. We are logged in as root on our first machine. It should be root, so it will allow modification. So existing file, it is used for local name resolution. So in production environment, we have registered domain names. You can find some details are here, but it may be same IP address or sometimes it may be different IP address. So I will check if it is same. So I will just test it here. So it is same IP address which I have checked here. Also, I will confirm 172.25.230.236. So this file which I have checked, it is having that name also and this IP address also. So for first machine, it is okay. Second machine, I will check. It may change because it is obtained by DHCP. So sometimes it may be same, sometimes it will be different. Here you can find 231.78. So I will check. Same 231.78. Yes, third one 230.245. So here it is changed. So I will change that line for insert and VM. So if you need VM related help also, like if you are not familiar with VM, VM is programmer editor. We have to use proper modes. Like I have pressed I for insert. Yes. Okay. Then no problem. Sometimes clients are not familiar, so I have to guide for that I for insert modification. Then how to save it. That also requires. So okay, it's good. So I am using 230.245. Okay, so confirming again 236.78 and this 230 also. Sometimes it is 230, sometimes 231. So that important details. 230.236. Then it is 231.78. And here it is 230.245. And for my systems, it is this IP address. You can use same names, but IP addresses in this third and fourth field for your systems, it may differ. So you have to use details from your system like this. You can check from this system. So,
if you go to the first system, uh-huh, that is 236, no? That IP, that is the...
Yes. 230.236, yes.
So here okay. 78 and 245 is the... nodes. Okay.
Puppet it now. Is Puppet. First one. First is Puppet.
Hmm.
So 230.236 is the first machine.
Same three so lines needs to be pasted in every VM, right?
Yes. So what we will do, we'll create this file on one machine and we'll use one utility command to copy this file instead of creating multiple times. So we'll copy this file to other machines. This node one, node two. We are creating on this Puppet machine and we will send this file to our other machines. So how to do that? I will show that also. So that prerequisite. So file is ready now. So I will save it, escape colon WQ to save. And just for confirmation and just for output, I will use cat etc hosts and I will keep a note of these. Sometimes if it is changed, and sometimes for reference also, if it is required, I will open one more utility, that is a notepad related utility, text editor, gedit. Actually, it is gedit, like Windows notepad. I will paste these details here. I will save it on desktop. Just for reference, if required. Generally, it is not required. But I will mention IP address and names. So IP hyphen. So on desktop, just IP and this file I have written just for reference. Okay, so this file is ready now. And now how to send it? In Linux by default, SSH SCP is there. So SSH is for remote access, secure shit like Telnet in Windows. And using SSH in background, we can use secure copy. SCP means secure copy. And we will send this etc host file. Okay.
So we can directly SCP the host file, right? Why are we saving it on the notepad then?
No, it is for reference, I have mentioned. I am directly sending it by command.
Okay.
Just for one more reference, I have kept in notepad also. Sometimes we need that name or IP address for reference to confirm is it changed or not. Sometimes just for that, as a backup, I'm using it. Okay. So etc host this file from local machine. I'm sending to node one. I'm using node one now because this entry is there now in etc host. So this node one will be resolved with this IP address from our etc host file. And I'm sending on node one colon separated etc host. So colon I'm using between there. It is a remote machine, a remote path, and source is the local file. So source and destination. First time it may ask yes, no, but if it is already configured, it may not. And it is asking for the password. That password is Red Hat. So for root password, CentOS. Generally in Linux, I use Red Hat. It is CentOS here. So I will mention that root's password here. You can keep in your note also, you can mention
CentOS
root user's password. Yes, it is simple password. CentOS.
Yes, got it
out. Okay. And yes, it is sent to node one. Same command repeat on node.
CentOS all lowercase, right?
Yes, yes, small letters.
Mm. Okay.
Lowercase CentOS. So this first step we have completed. Created a file and sent it to multiple machines. And now we will have a remote access also, so that no need to access like this. We have accessed console of this machine, then we can access console of second machine, then access console of third machine. Every time we have to switch from first machine to second, third. So we can do that also, but we can use utility like remote access. So here SCP utility command we have used to send file. I will open one tab from file menu also, it is available in browser itself. One more tab, so multiple tabs I'm opening. First tab for Puppet, second tab I will SSH to node one and second to node.
Okay.
So remote access, so no need to go graphically from one window to another. It is convenient, but we have to take care also. Sometimes we have to run commands on Puppet and we run that command on node. So that confusion also will be there. So we have to check always it is Puppet master, it is node one or node. So here I'm accessing node one and SSH root at the rate node. So directly as a root. And in production, we don't use directly root. Here we are in lab environment, so we are using direct root. Generally we use sudo. Yes, I have used Red Hat again. So send to us. And you can find we are on node one. Same command. SSH root at the rate node two. Password send to us. Yes. We are on node 2, so you can find here it is showing title, that is root puppet 1, root node 1, root node 2. So now next task, when we say on puppet, we will come here. When that node says it is node 1, we will come here and do that task. And when it is saying node 2, we will come here.